During a battle between Piltover and the Undercity, Zaun, Vi, and Powder's parents end up dead, leaving the sisters alone and helpless in the carnage's aftermath. However, Vander, one of the Undercity's fighters, takes the little girls under his wing. Years later, the sisters have now settled in the Undercity of Zaun, spending time on the streets as raiders. Echo, who's always been privy to certain bits of information, gives the sisters a tip about a jackpot in a Piltover penthouse. So, they head over there with their friends, Kligor and Milo. During the raid, Powder finds some mysterious crystal balls and takes them. When someone then tries to access the room, the group quickly packs up, but one crystal ball falls off and explodes, destroying parts of the room and the building. The explosion draws the attention of the enforcers, who chase them heatedly through the streets. Eventually, they escape, only to butt heads with Silco's men, the criminal boss in Zaun. In the ensuing fight, the kids lose the loot. When they get home, a pissed and concerned Vander reprimands them, as word of the theft has already gone out. Afterward, he goes to meet with Grayson, an enforcer with whom he struck an understanding to keep the peace between both cities. She asks him for a name regarding the heist, but Vander refuses. Meanwhile, Crime Lord Silco and his team are working on a new mutagen known as Shimmer. Jace, the owner of the raided penthouse, gets arrested because he's in possession of restricted equipment. In prison, Professor Heimerdinger visits him and Jace reveals he's been trying to harness magic through science. However, Heimerdinger tells him it's dangerous and admonishes him to apologize and let go of his experiment during his trial in exchange for a lighter sentence. Back in Zaun, Vi, Powder, Milo, and Kligor almost get caught by enforcers, but Echo steps in and helps them escape. Later that day, he tells the sisters about Vander's deal with Grayson, after listening in on their conversation. At Piltover, Jace goes against Heimerdinger's advice during his trial, and ends up getting expelled from the academy. Meanwhile, Silco arranges a deal with Marcus, an enforcer, and tips him on the children's whereabouts. Afterward, Marcus goes over to the last drop, Vander's bar, but he doesn't find the children, as Vander had already warned them ahead. Dejected by his sentence, Jace gets a visit from Victor, Heimerdinger's assistant, and is enthralled when Victor offers to help him complete his research. Simultaneously, Grayson receives a message bearing the name of one of the penthouse thieves. It turns out that Vi, to keep her friends safe, has decided to hand herself over to the authorities, but she does this without Vander's knowledge. Despite Vi's plans, Vander gets to her in time and hides her away before the enforcers arrive. When Grayson and Marcus arrive, Vander covers up for the children and turns himself in. However, when they try to leave, Silco and his Shimmer-created monster attack them, killing Grayson and Benzo, and capturing Vander. Having witnessed the horrific turnout of events, Echo tells Vi about Vander's capture and where Silco would take him. Vi, Kligor, and Milo attempt to rescue him, but decide to leave Powder behind. Unknown to them, Powder follows, and after having realized the destructive capabilities of the crystal balls, she creates a bomb with them. When Vi and the group then get attacked, Powder deploys her newfound toys, but things get out of hand, and the explosions kill her friends, Milo and Kligor. Seeing Vi so close to death, a dying Vander takes the Shimmer and saves her. Concurrently, after getting help from Ambassador Mel Medarda, one of the council members, Jace and Victor, complete the experiment, which they call Hextech. Afterward, it gets accepted by the council, despite Heimerdinger's objections. Back in Zaun, Vander dies, and Powder approaches a weeping Vi, revealing that she's responsible for the explosions. Infuriated, Vi slaps Powder and storms out, driving her little sister to Silco's warm embrace. When she comes to, Vi tries to go rescue Powder from Silco, but Marco drugs her and takes her away. A few years later, Hextech has brought significant development to Piltover. but that has only widened the gap between it and Zaun, leading to more crimes. On a Piltover shipping dock, where Silco transports his shimmer, Civica, Silco's lieutenant, and her team get attacked by firelighters, a ravaging group with a hatred for Shimmer. As they destroy the shipments, Powder, who now goes by Jinx, shows up. During the shootout, she sees someone that reminds her of Vi, and gets mentally unstable, wounding one of her own. Meanwhile, Caitlin, the daughter of one of the ruling houses in Piltover, has become an enforcer, going against the ruling class's traditional ways. When she hears about the attack, she goes to the docks and finds one of Silco's thugs shot. However, before she can question him, Marcus steps in and sends her away. Frightened that Silco would leave her just like Vi, Jinx goes out to show him she's capable. She kills a group of enforcers, almost killing Caitlin as well, and steals the Hextech gemstone along with Jace's research. As expected, the theft of the gemstone pleases Silco. The death of the enforcers creates a panic in Piltover, and Jace gets appointed as counselor in order to get things under control. In the wake of the incident, Caitlin's parents get her fired from the force to save her, but it doesn't stop her from making her own investigations, which eventually leads to meeting Vi in prison. After a little chat, Caitlin gets Vi out of prison so she can help with her investigation, and they head down to Zaun. Meanwhile, Jace's new appointment as counselor gets pesky with other council members who are disadvantaged by his anti-corruption campaign. However, with Mel's help, he gets back in favor. Still, on their investigation, Vi and Caitlin find Sevica and learn that Powder now works for Silco. Concurrently, Jinx tries to use the crystals to make weapons, but she keeps getting visions of Milo, Kligor, and Vander's death. However, Silco helps her get over the mental disturbance, and she continues with her work. Back at Piltover, the ill Victor who's been trying to figure out the Hex Core, an adaptation of the technology capable of bringing dead or dying things back to life, gets a reaction from it when his blood touches it. But he falls unconscious, and doesn't get to witness it. Afterward, he learns of his imminent death. Back in Zaun, Sevica and Vi get into a fight. When Sevica tries to deliver the killing blow, Caitlin shoots her, and she escapes. She goes over to Silco's and relays news of Vi's survival, leaving the man in shock. After discovering that Vi's alive, Silco sends out men to search for her. As Vi and Caitlin try to evade capture, they're unaware that they're being watched by a member of the Firelights. Jinx also learns that Vi is alive, and goes in search of her. In Piltover, Heimerdinger asks Jace to destroy the Hexcore technology. Unhappy with his mentor's perception of their work, Jace gets Heimerdinger out of the council. Back in Zaun, Vi and Caitlin find somewhere to hide. With Vi injured, Caitlin goes out in search of a doctor, and gets help from one of Vander's old friends. The treatment gets Vi to her feet in no time. However, they have to leave quickly when Silco catches up to them. On the run, Vi sees a blue flare in the sky and knows it's her sister. On seeing each other, Vi and Jinx hold themselves in a warm hug, and Vi explains why she hadn't come for her all those years ago. The reunion turns sour as soon as Caitlin shows up. As Vi tries to calm things down, they get attacked by firelights. In the ensuing fight, Vi gets shocked by what her sister has turned into. Eventually, the firelights capture Caitlin, Vi, and Jinx's gemstone, leaving Jinx all alone again. When they get to the Firelights' hideout, Vi discovers their leader is Echo, who reveals that Silco is using Shimmer as a drug to control the people in Zaun. The two are able to get along, and she gets him to send Caitlin and the gemstone back to Piltover. Echo agrees to go with her. Hellbent on stabilizing Hexcore, Victor visits an old friend who is also a scientist, and the creator of Shimmer. There, Victor gets a chance to extend his life by taking the new variant of Shimmer his friend is making, and he takes it. Although, the scientist warns him that Piltover will reject him once he takes the Shimmer. Because of the havoc Jinx has wreaked on Piltover, Jace closes the bridge linked to Zaun. The move creates a lot of tension between both cities as the move freezes the border trade. Meanwhile, after realizing that the Undercity could make weapons with the Hextech they stole, The council asks Jace and Victor to create weapons of their own. On the way to the border, Vi opts to stay back in Zaun for Jinx, leaving Caitlin and Echo to continue the mission. However, Marcus attacks them at the border with a squad of enforcers. During the fight, Echo is shot and Caitlin is almost killed, but Jinx wades in and blows the place up, killing Marcus and the enforcers. Upon hearing the commotion, Vi turns around and heads right back to the bridge. When Jinx tries to take the gemstone, Echo stands up to her and they get into a fight. Defeated by Echo's superior skill and strength, Jinx sets off another bomb and injures them both. After arriving in Piltover, Caitlin and Vi realize Jinx has the gemstone. Simultaneously, Silco finds Jinx at the brink of death and takes her to his scientist, who resuscitates her with the new Shimmer variant. When Vi and Caitlin get to her house, they get Lady Kiriman, Caitlin's mother, to schedule an audience with the council. Meanwhile, Mel's mom visits to use her daughter's relationship with Jace to gain access to Hextech, but Mel turns her down. After being kicked out of the council, Heimerdinger walks into Zaun and faces hostility from its residents. As he heads towards the bridge, he finds Echo with a broken leg and helps him back to the Undercity. When Vi's meeting with the counselors doesn't go well, she leaves, telling Caitlin to forget about her. Afterward, she visits Jace and talks him into destroying Silco's factories, in which super soldiers are created with Shimmer. At the same time, Victor accidentally gets his assistant, who also has feelings for him, killed while working on Hexcore. While Vi is out destroying Silco's factories with Jace, Jinx pays Caitlin a visit. Jace and Vi meet resistance at one of Silco's factories and successfully squash it. However, Jace kills a child and backs out of the arrangement with Vi. Undeterred, Vi continues without him. After seeing the level of destruction Hexcore is capable of, Victor makes Jace a promise to destroy it. Afterward, Jace requests a parley with Silco. When Silco honors it, he proposes a deal to get Jinx in exchange for the Undercity's independence, an idea that's been a lifelong dream for Silco. Now, he seems to be caught between two tough decisions. However, Jinx finds out about the deal and knocks Silco out. When Heimerdinger goes over to Echo's place, he's amazed by the world the young man has created, away from Silco's influence. Elsewhere, Vi engages Sevica in a fight and beats the hell out of her. After that, Vi goes after Silco, but Jinx knocks her out before she can do that. When she wakes up, she finds herself, Caitlin, and Silco at a table with Jinx. They get into a conversation where Vi and Silco vie for Jinx's affection. However, Jinx kills Silco when he tries to kill Vi. Realizing that she will never regain the old bond she had with her older sister, Jinx decides to strike an irreversible path. Meanwhile, in Piltover, Jace and Victor let the counselors in on his deal with Silco, but this creates a great uproar in the hall as they're against it. However, Mel gets all of them to agree with Jace's move for peace. Hence, they're caught unawares when an unsettled Jinx uses the gemstone to fire it as a rocket toward the council hall where they're all gathered and have just decided to give Zaun its independence.